On February 11th, at their Unpacked event, Samsung unveiled their Galaxy S20 lineup of flagship smartphones. A total of three smartphones make up the Galaxy S20 line. We have the Galaxy S20, the Galaxy S20 Plus, and of course, the Galaxy S20 Ultra. That's kind of making the headlines for its crazy specs. These phones start at $1,000 on the low end for the S20 and go all the way up to $1,400 for the S20 Ultra, even more if you decide to get more RAM and more storage. Now, the other, arguably the most exciting phone Samsung announced at the event, although I don't want to discredit the Galaxy S20 line because Samsung did upgrade almost every area of the devices compared to last year's Galaxy S10 variants, but anyway, that is the Galaxy Z Flip. The Z Flip is essentially a 2020 version of a flip phone from the mid-2000s, complete with an OLED foldable glass display, the first of its kind, and flagship-like specifications. It's most similar to the new Moto Razr. But what's most appealing to me, aside from obviously the design, is its price of $1,300, $1,380 to be exact, which, puts it right in line with the Galaxy S20 Ultra. In fact, it's also probably the cheapest foldable you can buy right now. So what this means is you have the choice between taking the risk of buying a new foldable smartphone that's brand new to the market, or for essentially the same price, going with a more traditional device with some of the highest end specs and components of any smartphone we've seen. So let's first talk about specifications, and then I'll provide some of my thoughts. With the Galaxy Z Flip, you get a 6.7-inch 1080 by 2626 resolution AMOLED display, 12-megapixel main f1.8-megapixel sensor, and 12-megapixel ultra-wide sensor on the rear, with a 10-megapixel selfie camera up front. There's a Snapdragon 855 Plus CPU with 8 gigs of RAM, 3300 milliamp-hour battery with wireless charging, and a side-mounted fingerprint scanner. Feel free to pause this page to view all the other specs mentioned on GSM Arena. Those are some very solid specifications for a foldable smartphone. They're not quite on the same caliber as the Galaxy S20 variants, but they pretty much blow the Moto Razr out of the water, which is really the only foldable with this form factor. As for the Galaxy S20 Ultra, it features a 6.9-inch AMOLED display with a max resolution of 1440 by 3200 pixels and a 120Hz refresh rate. There's the latest and greatest Snapdragon 865 chipset with 12 or 16 gigabytes of RAM, 108-megapixel main camera, 48-megapixel telephoto sensor, 12-megapixel ultra-wide camera, a time-of-flight sensor, 40-megapixel selfie camera, you got stereo speakers, an ultrasonic in-display fingerprint scanner, and massive 5,000-milliamp-hour battery with support for 45-watt fast charging and, of course, wireless charging. Once again, feel free to pause this video and look at the additional specs on GSM Arena. Another thing to note is the Z Flip is a 4G smartphone, while the S20 Ultra will support the complete set of 5G standards, so it will be a little bit more future-proof if you're thinking about upgrading to 5G in the next couple of years. Honestly, the specs, though, aren't too terribly different. However, it's still pretty clear, I think, for most people that the Ultra just goes above and beyond in almost every area to make it the most feature-packed smartphone on the market. Now, what the Galaxy S20 Ultra does not offer is really anything new in the build department. In fact, Samsung actually removed the signature curved edges that pretty much defined Galaxy phones for the past few years, and they've opted in favor of a more traditional flat display. So it's arguably even more boring than ever in its design language. The Galaxy Z Flip, on the other hand, it provides the first foldable smartphone with a glass display, and one of the first smartphones to fold across the X-axis. So it's easily gonna provide the most nostalgic and refreshing experience of almost any phone on the market. You're gonna get some looks, that's for sure, when you're using this phone, and you're probably gonna get some questions about the device if you do decide to pick up the Z Flip. So, if you're bored with smartphones and you're looking for a completely new experience, I think the Galaxy Z Flip is definitely going to be the best choice. With that said, for almost every other reason, the Galaxy S20 Ultra is gonna be the option I would recommend. With a Generation 1 device like the Z Flip, there's inevitably going to be some kinks to work out. We don't know how long the phone will last before it stops flipping. We don't know how durable the hinge is. We don't know if the battery will even last a full day on a single charge, or if there are any real advantages of a foldable screen that folds across the X-axis as opposed to a device that folds across the Y-axis, like the Galaxy Fold that turns into a miniature tablet. For only 20 bucks more, the Galaxy S20 Ultra will provide all of these specs and features to last you easily 2 years before needing or even entertaining the idea of upgrading devices. And of course, the reason why I'm talking about these two devices is because of how similarly priced they are. You're still spending $1,300-$1,400 for a smartphone, so I mean, your decision shouldn't be taken lightly. That's a lot of money, especially when you can get a really good phone for like 500 bucks or less now. So I'm just hoping that this video helps you decide between the two, but there's a lot of phones out there, let's be honest. I also wanna say, I haven't actually tested these phones out in person, so my views could certainly change, but those are my thoughts, my current thoughts on the Galaxy Z Flip and the Galaxy S20 Ultra. Hopefully I can help some of you decide on which device to order. Let me know your thoughts. What are you thinking about the Galaxy Z Flip or the S20 Ultra? What do you like or dislike? I'm curious to hear your thoughts in a comment down below. As always, I'm Bo HD from PhoneDog.com. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you right back here in the next one. See ya.